Good morning, everyone. It's 8 a.m. in the morning, and I am Cheshta with the Morning Tales for June 7, 2019. So before starting with the video, let me just tell you about the 10 mocks of phase 1 and 5 mocks of phase 2, which are available in our NABARD graded 2019 mocks course, where we are providing the mocks for ₹999. So the gross amount is ₹1500, but we are providing the mocks for ₹999, that too by using the coupon code MOCKS MOCKS. So you can use this coupon code to avail the discount and you can get the mock test for ₹999. Now let's begin with the first question. So the first question is asking about the which of the following has launched the India's first product which tells about the real-time bus travel information specific to public transport. So this is for the first time that the three India specific features have been launched and they are related to use of the public transport. So Google Maps have come up with this application, or we could say these three features, the product which tells about the real-time bus travel information. So there are three features which have been launched. The first one tells about the real-time bus timing. So it tells about the accurate bus travel times that are based on the live traffic. Also, it has been as of now launched in 10 cities. So Delhi, Bangalore, Mumbai, Hyderabad, Pune, Lucknow, Chennai, Mysore, Coimbatore and Surat, they have been upgraded with this Google Maps where they can find the live traffic of bus public transport. Another feature is related to the real-time information related to the trains. So now Google Maps can help the users to find out when their train is going to arrive, also by indicating the real-time status. Another has been launched with respect to the auto rickshaws. So auto rickshaws, it's the feature where you can combine the auto rickshaws and the public transport. So the public transport tab, which will be available on the Google map, it would tell you that when is the auto rickshaw taking or the public transport journey is a good option for you and how much time will it take for you to travel from one place to another place, or how could you use the auto rickshaw or which auto rickshaw facility is available. You can all find out on their Google Maps application. Now these are first of its kind features which have been launched in India, therefore it becomes important. Moving on to the next question. So where was the second Global Disability Summit observed? So first question which should come in your mind was that second Global Disability Summit was related to 2019. So current year observed the second Global Disability Summit, and the first Global Disability Summit was observed in 2018 and that too in London. Now coming to the second Global Disability Summit, so it was observed in Argentina. Now as the name suggests, Global Disability Summit, so this summit is related to the empowerment and inclusion of the persons with disabilities. So the PWD candidates or people across the world, we need to empower those people and how mechanisms and technology could be used to make their life independent and dignified. So this is the purpose of the Global Disability Summit. First was observed in London 2018 and second is observed in Argentina in 2019. So next question is, which of the foreign state has recently launched the Digital Sakhi program? Now this Digital Sakhi program was earlier launched in Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. Now after the successful implementation of this similar program in these two states, now it has been launched in Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu has come up with this Digital Sakhi program, which aims at including or which aims at the digital financial inclusion of the rural women. So it is with respect to the rural women and it's the part of the financial inclusion. So one of the initiatives taken by the Tamil Nadu government for this financial inclusion is this Digital Sakhi program. So Digital Sakhi is someone or a rural woman with its digital device who is equipped with the skills and knowledge so that they could impart the digital financial literacy trainings to others. So it means that once you are trained with the digital knowledge, you could impart the same knowledge to others as well. So this is what the initiative of Digital Sakhi program is. Also, it has been launched as a part of the CSR responsibility of Larsen & Toubro. Next question and quite important question with respect to the examination, NABARD basically. So what is the amount of the scholarship for boys under the Prime Minister's scholarship scheme under NDA? Now first of all, what is this NDA? So NDA stands for National Defence Fund, which was actually set up in the year 1962 to take charge of the voluntary donations which are being received in cash and kind. So to promote the national defense effort of the people. So this is what the purpose of this fund was. Now coming to the amount of scholarship. So on the first day at office, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, during his second term, he increased the money in the awarded under this scholarship for the children of the armed forces. And not only armed forces, but of the paramilitary forces as well, and the railway protection forces, which are killed in the line of duty. So the new scholarship amount has been increased from 2000 to 2500 for boys, which is for per month, and for girls the amount earlier was 20 to 500, now it has been increased to 3000 per month for all the girls. So for boys it has been increased to 2000 from 2000 to 2500. So the answer of this question is 2500 per month. Not only this, the scheme has been extended to the wards of the state police personnel who were killed in terrorist and Maoist violence. So three major changes have been made. First one, that it has been extended to include the wards of the state police personnel who were killed in the terrorist and the Maoist violence. Next, the amount of scholarship has been increased from 2000 to 2500 for boys, and earlier it was 2250 for girls, now it has been increased to 3000 per month. So it's important to remember this Prime Minister scholarship scheme. Now there's a question for all of you, that under which ministry this Prime Minister scholarship scheme comes. So you need to mention in the comment section below that which ministry governs the Prime Minister scholarship scheme under the National Defence Fund. The next question is, World Bank has projected India's growth forecast for current financial year at. So for the current financial year, as per the Global Economic Prospects report, which is released by the World Bank, the India's growth forecast has been pegged at the same pace of 7.5%, and this is for the current financial year. Earlier, IMF actually cut down the economic growth of India to 7.3%, and earlier it projected it to be 7.5%. So in April 2019, it projected that India would grow at 7.3%. Similarly, the Asian Development Bank, it pegged the growth at 7.2%. So World Bank at 7.5%, these all are for the current fiscal year. And as per this, the World Bank has projected India's GDP to be 7.3 has been projected by IMF and 7.2 by ADB. Earlier, IMF projected 7.5%, but now it has cut down to 7.3% of GDP forecast. Moving on to the next question and quite important question with respect to the examination. So, when is the World Food Safety Day observed? When is the World Food Safety Day observed? So, we observe this day today, that is June 7th, 2019. Why 2019 is important? Because this is for the first time that we are going to observe the World Food Safety Day. So June 7th is the day when we observe this World Food Safety Day, and for the first time we are going to observe it in 2019. What is the theme for the World Food Safety Day? So it is food safety, everyone's business. So food safety, everyone's business is the theme for the World Food Safety Day, and there are some measures or five key ways to keep the safer food. The first one is keep clean. Another one is separate raw and cooked food. Next one is cook thoroughly. Another one is keep food at the same safe temperatures, and the last one is use safe water and raw materials. So this day is observed. So we are observing this day from today onwards so that we could get the access to sufficient amount of safe and nutritious food for sustaining our lives. Therefore, to promote this, the World Health Organization is going to observe, along with the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United States, this World Food Safety Day. That is on June 7, 2019. It's very important. It's the first time we are observing it. Now it's time for you to mention your answers in the comment section that what is the name of the organization that has launched this Confetti, that is the first interactive game show. It's very important to know that it's the first interactive game show which has been launched by the organization. So do mention your answers in the comment section below that Confetti is the first interactive game show of which organization. Also, you need to mention in the comment section that which ministry observes the or under which ministry the Pradhan Mantri scholarship scheme comes. So tell me in the comment section which ministry governs the Pradhan Mantri scholarship scheme. So this is all for the today's morning tale. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel Anu Jindal and in fact press the bell icon so that you do not miss on any of the notification when the video is being posted. Also, I hope you are preparing well for the NABARD examination. So just to keep a check on your knowledge, do buy the mock test and do prepare yourself with the mock test so that you can clear the exam easily. All the best for your examination and thank you so much for watching the video.